This is a short lecture about abstraction. Abstraction is one of the seven big ideas of the CS principles curriculum that we're using in this course. And we're going to see lots of computer science examples. Abstracting is the process of creating abstractions. It's one of the main computational thinking skills we're going to be learning. But what exactly is an abstraction? And what exactly do we do when we create one? An abstraction is a general representation of something, of some person or place or event or process, of anything. Abstractions are formed by including only those details needed to make the abstraction useful to us in some way. You use abstractions all the time, although you probably don't call them that. You couldn't really speak or think without abstractions. So words, ideas, concepts, maps, models, symbols, all of these things are examples of abstractions that we use every day to think about and talk about the world. So let's look at some simple examples. A map is an abstraction. A map contains less information than the world that it's representing. In this case, we have a treasure map, and it's reduced the information about the world down to a simple image, with an X marking the spot where the treasure is. If you think of a Google map of directions from your home to school, it's the same sort of thing. Details are removed so you can focus in on the directions. And we create a map by including only those details in it that will make it useful to us. If our purpose is getting from point A to point B, we don't need to see all the trees and the mailboxes, etc., on the way to point B. So that's a nice example of an abstraction. A model, in this case a model airplane, is an example of an abstraction. Notice how the model contains much less information than the real plane. Again, here we create the model by leaving out details or by including only those details or features of the plane that is useful to us in terms of why we're making that model. A floor plan is another example. Notice how this floor plan contains much less information than the space it represents. All we really see are the relationship between the living room, the dining room, the hall, and so on. We don't see any furniture or carpets. And again, we create this kind of abstraction by including only those details that are useful to us. So that's a nice example. An idea or a concept is a great example of an abstraction. And these are formed through a mental process that happens pretty much automatically as we learn about our world from infancy through old age. And again here, the idea is that the concept encapsulates only those details that are necessary for making it a useful concept. For example, a concept of a chair doesn't include any specifics about what is it made of, how big is it, what color is it? It only includes the essential information that a chair is something that we can sit on. This idea of thinking in abstractions is really a fundamental part of human behavior. It's really the way we perceive and think about the world. Another nice example are the words we use. And words are some of the most abstract examples of abstractions. They're abstract in the sense that they have no similarity with the objects that they represent. So the word for chair is just a string of letters. It has no shape. It doesn't have the shape of a chair or four legs and so on. So we've abstracted away all the details of chairs and we're left with just the fundamental idea that a chair is something you can sit on. And learning that words represent things is a fundamental skill that we acquire as we learn our language. So that's a nice example. How about in computer science? What we've seen in the previous examples is the abstractions are made by a process of simplifying and condensing and encapsulating the features into an artifact like a map or like an airplane that represents something much more complex. This is an important problem-solving skill in computer science. And abstractions are used in hardware and software to help reduce the complexity of our systems and to make them easier to use and understand. We're going to look at a couple of examples from software. So in programming languages and computer languages, both variables and constants are examples of abstractions. A constant is a symbol that represents a single thing. For example, the numeral 5 represents only the value 5. It can't represent the value 10. By contrast, a variable, like the symbol x, can represent any number. It can represent 5 or 10 or 14 or minus 10. As we'll see, we're going to use variables to make our programs more general. So that's one example. Another example is a procedure. And computer languages have procedures for performing all kinds of calculations. Take, for example, the square root procedure. What you know about this procedure is that if you give it a number, it will produce a square root of that number. And the procedure, for example, is built into your calculator, into your computer, into our phones. And it's built into our programming languages like App Inventor. But that procedure actually represents something very complex. A very complex calculation is going on in the background that we no longer remember the details of. That's the beauty of the abstraction. As long as we know that if we give it the number 5, it will give us back the square root of 5. That's all we need to know in order to use that procedure successfully. So we'll be making lots of use of both built-in procedures and procedures that we create. We're going to create our own abstractions as we learn more and more about programming in App Inventor. So to summarize, an abstraction is a general and simplified representation of something. Words, symbols, maps, models are all examples. And abstracting is the process of removing details or including only those details that are necessary in order to use the abstraction for some purpose.